Hello guys and welcome back to the boss tutorials. This is the time we are going to fight Vendrick. That's right, the former king, because we are now the king. So before even thinking about fighting Vendrick, what you want to do is knowing something. Now, first of all, this guy won't aggro you ever. Alright, unless you hit him. See? He doesn't care. Now let's just get out of here for a second. And see, there is no fog wall, there is nothing. He's not hostile versus you. So, I mean, this is a complete optional boss. You don't need to fight him. Alright? You do because, I mean, he gives you souls and you can open a secret door in the Shrine of Amana. But apart from that, it's completely optional. You don't need him. To fight him, what do you need? Now keep in mind, this guy has insane defense. Okay, you basically, I mean, you could hit him all the time for I don't know, I think hours, and he won't even notice. But there's a trick to that. You need to have Souls of Giants. All right, now. He starts up with basically 32 times his usual defense when you have no Souls of Giants. If you have one Soul of Giants, he has 16 times his defense. If you have two Soul of Giants, he has 8, and 4, and 2, and then 1. So the maximum you can get is 5 Souls of Giants. Well, no, I mean, you can get basically unlimited if you ascetic the Black Gulch and you kill the two giants down there and. They give you a Soul of Giants every time. I did it once because I have yet to kill the Ancient Dragon. We're going to do that and it would be fun. But if you have 5, Vendrick has normal defense. And you can damage him. I mean, normally, you can do enough damage to him that you can kill him, alright? There's another problem though. When he hits, you die. And, well, I mean, it depends on your defense, on how many HPs you have, but if he hits you, you're going to feel it. Trust me on that. What you want to do here is not use a shield, and you should trust me even on that. Maybe a great shield, but I mean, unless you have such a high stability and so much stamina, it will be hard to block him. Because, you know, with a great shield you can block one hit. You can. And if you have enough stability, you can block two hits. If you have really, really high stability, really, really high stamina, maybe you can block three hits. Which is his longest combo. Problem is, you don't know before he starts. I mean, the first strike that he does, you don't know if he's going to do a second one and a third one. It could stop at the second, it could go on to the third, or it could stop at the first one. Which means using a shield is not really. I mean, I don't feel like tell you to use a shield. I mean, it's most certainly possible to kill this boss with a shield. I'm not saying it isn't, but I feel much better rolling through his attacks. Actually. As you'll see, we're not even going to do that because it's like a truck. He has great HPs, and if you don't have this Soul of a Giant in your inventory, he's basically immortal. He has a great weakness. A great weakness that I actually found on my own. Now I'm sure there are thousands of videos that explain what weakness it is, but I died a lot to this boss in my first playthrough. You can see it in my first blind run. It is on YouTube if you want to check it out. And I died a lot to this guy until I found something. I have two words for you, and these words are left leg. So now what do you want to do with this guy? Is to, well, I mean, I buff my weapon. You cannot. I don't care. Whatever you want. And And I don't... Well, yeah, you can lock on to this guy. And what you want to do is stay basically here, alright? I'm going to hit him a couple of times, he should, alright, should aggro us. And what you want to do is stay here. Right, did you see the damage he did to us? Yeah, that's a lot of damage. Now, apart from his left leg, you really want to keep him in the center of the room. It is pretty important. And then you want to keep staying basically here, alright? He can't get you here, see? Wait until he attacks. Here he goes. And one, two, whatever many hits you can get in. And keep keep strafing on the right. But you see where I'm standing in? Alright. You need to keep standing here. This is the only safe spot. Alright. Now, there is... obviously, you can fight it normally by... basically just roll through every attack he does. I find that is not really reliable because I fought it the first time. I think I had 4 Swords of a Giant, so he had double his defense, and the fight was so long that after some time you're going to make some mistakes. But see, it is a really easy boss once you figure this out. Left leg, guys. Left leg. You need to stay close to his left leg. I can't stress this enough. You basically need to be glued. Alright? And then you bash on him. Which, whatever weapon you have, you just need to do enough damage to, you know... to do enough, I mean, to get him. But apart from that, you can use whatever you want. And you don't even need the armor here. I mean, I survived one hit. I got hit, I wasn't paying attention. I'm glad I got hit, so you saw the damage he does to us. I have a pretty good armor here. It's a Dragon Mage plus 5. I mean, it's... I mean, I don't know, I'm not wearing a helmet. I am cosplaying here. I'm not perfect, but Dragon Mage isn't a... horrible armor. It's, I mean, it's a pretty nice armor. And he took out Alfaruar HPs. So, yeah. What you really want to do is stick to his left leg. Do not let go, ever. And ideally, you should stay in the center of the room. As longer as you progress, and you know, maybe a second, third playthrough, whatever, you'll get much more confident on fighting him and fighting everything in the game. And then you can fight him, I don't know, like, even if he's not in the center, who cares? You can still, you know, get around him, do something, I mean, roll sometimes, it's not like you have... But if it's your first time, glue, alright? You are glue, you should... Let's just say you're a mosquito on his left leg, alright? Stay there. And you'll win. Maybe not the first time because you screwed something up, maybe... I mean, I did when I found out about this because I noticed that he couldn't kill me when I stand there. I did try at least another couple of times before I could kill him. And, you know, it happens. Because it does so much damage that the second you screw up, you die. So, just stay on his left leg and you'll succeed. Maybe not the first, maybe not the second time, but you will. Alright, you saw that. I mean, he barely ever touched me. He touched me once because I was stupid, but other than that, he never touched me again. So, you know? Left leg. So, goodbye, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.